and welcome to The Driven Millennial. I'm your host, Mia Sarno, and we're talking fast and easy tips for peak performance without burnout today with Ms. Hope Zvara. Hi there.
Hi, thanks for having me.
You're so welcome. I'm glad you're here. She is the owner of Mother Trucker Yoga, which is really cool and interesting, and I'll let her kind of dive into her story and share with you. But it's good to say we're getting tips on breath work today. So hi there, Hope. Let us know what's up.
Hi, thanks so much for having me. I always like to start out with kind of letting people know how I fell into what I fell into, because the first response usually is like yoga and truckers. Like, how do those two go together? But I found yoga about 20 years ago, or better yet, yoga found me when I was knee deep in an eating disorder and I was struggling with depression and anxiety and overwhelm. And I just kind of felt like, what is in it for me? And I stumbled across yoga. And yoga changed my life. I still remember that first yoga class, rolling up my mat and walking out the door and looking back and going, oh my gosh, it was the first time in years that my mind wasn't busy, that my body wasn't feeling anxious. And I had felt this like relaxation within the stillness of nothing, which normally nothingness meant anxiety. And I was hooked. And eventually that led me to a yoga teacher training. Eventually that led me to opening my yoga studio. Within that time frame, I married my high school sweetheart. And on the road to recovery with my yoga, my husband and I got married and we got pregnant. And you would think that that's an exciting time, except, except on May 23rd, 2007, my husband and I got news that no new parent should ever hear. And we were told that our daughter was not going to make it.
I'm so sorry. And
at a point in our life, or in my life, where everyone was walking on eggshells, thinking I'm going to relapse, thinking I'm going to go back into addiction, go back into this place that I had worked so hard to get out of, the loss of my daughter, I did the exact opposite. And I excelled even more. It gave me more motive and more reason to keep moving forward and to keep finding my purpose and to keep sharing with others, to not lose hope. To not lose hope that there's an opportunity and a life out there for them, and that if you're still alive and breathing, there's purpose for you, there's value for you. And I held on to that for many, many years. And eventually I developed the process called the Hope Yoga Process, helping others purposefully excel. And that's led me now in the last 2 years to creating a company called Mother Trucker Yoga. My main goal is to help people learn how to live in their bodies again, following the three B's, breath, body, and belief. And so we're talking about breath today, and breath is the first thing that you're given in life and the last to be taken away. Yet it always amazes me that people, even yogis, wait until their last breath to decide that it's important. As someone that's been teaching yoga for almost 20 years, I find it interesting that you do breath work in the beginning and you can tell those people in the room that it's like, get this over with. Like, can we just like move on to do something? And in fact, that might be the most important and effective doing that you could possibly be in. And that's breathing. The breath is the first thing that you're given in life and the last to be taken away. So we're going to first and foremost slow everybody down here right now and just tune into our breathing. When is the last time that you actually checked into your breath and said, hey, this is why I'm alive right now? When is the last time you checked in and was like, okay, am I belly breathing? Or am I what I call clavicle breathing, which the average person breathes with about 18% of their lung capacity? No wonder that so much of our culture is anxious and it is depressed, is stressed, is overworked, can't sleep, can't focus, because we're not breathing. So if everyone sits tall, or if you're walking or standing or whatever it is you're doing listening to this right now, first of all, thank you for listening. I want you to stand or sit nice and tall and bring one hand to your belly and one hand to your chest. And if you're comfortable enough, if you're driving, don't do this and don't close your eyes. Just listen and do this. But I want you to close your eyes if you're able to. And on the inhalation, feel your belly expand. Notice if your body is resistant and feel your chest rise. And when you get to the edge of that inhalation, exhale through the nose and work to let all the air out. And let's just do that one more time. On the inhale, your belly expands. It does not contract. It goes out like a balloon. Your chest rises up. And then exhaling, working to let all the air out. Now you can open your eyes, and I know that was only two breaths, but this should give you a pretty good marker of where your anxiety is, where your connection with your breath and your body is. And if you're someone that is stressed, if you get easily agitated, if you don't sleep well, if you have digestive issues, very few people look to our breathing to solve those problems. And as someone that has made it through a lot of hardship and struggle personally and has been able to build a very successful business, well, actually two very successful businesses, my breath work is oftentimes my back pocket kind of go-to, because when I get distracted or I get out of focus, it's like, okay, Hope, I need to be in my body again. And I think that's why so many of us reach for other things, substance, sex, drugs, alcohol. For me, it was food. And being in my body was really uncomfortable. And yoga and breathing gave me this means to learn how to be okay with the discomfort.
Yeah, thank you so much for guiding us through that. And that's what we're talking about today with the fast and easy tips, because that was literally super fast. You should probably take maybe 10, not two. but then it was so easy. I mean, it is, and it's diving into, you know, it's okay for me to take 30 seconds. The to-do list isn't going to get bigger. And even if it does, you're going to be a better version of yourself within that to-do list, within all of the pressures that running a business take, being a good employee take, being a good parent take, whatever that is and whatever that stress is, you get to show up in a next level version of yourself.
I agree. And I think for many of us out there that are living a very high stressed life, if you think about it, even 10 breaths, I know for me, when I was really anxious, honey, you couldn't even get me to do 5 breaths, let alone just like close my eyes. So let's start really small. I like nuggets. I like small, easy, digestible things that I can instantly apply to my life with no stress. I challenge everyone listening to this at least once a day for the next 7 days to at least close your eyes once and take one very deep breath. And during that one deep breath, I want you to feel everything you're feeling. The inhalation through your nose, the belly expanding, the chest expanding, even the restriction of your body while breathing. Maybe it's a tight bra strap or your jeans on real tight, or it's just the fascia of your body pushing against your bone structure as you expand, whatever it is. And then really notice your exhalation. Pay attention to that until it's fully and completely over. That in itself is a meditation. I remember when I first started in yoga and I had this big idea of meditation being me sitting on a cushion in a beautiful place for 20 minutes and I'd be and just like in nirvana. And then I tried doing it. I was like, this is hard. Like, this is never going to happen. And I was realizing I was biting off a bigger expectation than what I was capable of doing. So I was failing before I even started. And when someone finally gave me permission that 1 minute was meditation and that doing only one thing at a time was meditation, it completely transformed my life. So I challenge you listening to do that with breathing. One breath, totally attentive, 7 days, and hopefully you start realizing that this is something that you can go to anytime, anywhere, and it's a tool that actually will help you.
Yes, thank you so much. And I want to challenge people too in that 7 days to do it when you think you don't have time to do it.
Yes.
That moment that you just finished a phone call or you're about to step into a meeting, and like the perception of how long 60 seconds is totally changes when you have to face yourself.
Yes. The life is not going to end in one breath. Like, the world is not going to turn upside down if you take yourself for a moment before you go back into the meeting or go deal with your kids or call someone or whatever it is. The world will not end if you unplug for 60 seconds.
Yeah, and that's great, because 10 breaths can be a lot sometimes. And I really appreciate what you said about just showing people that meditation can – we're going to start here. And I think that's what we talked about a lot, is I was like, I want the Driven Millennial to be something super accessible, and that it's not just for people my age or in my demographic, but it's they're nuggets that will last a lifetime. And that nugget thing you're going to see throughout this whole series is, what are those nuggets? And what are things like this recording you guys can listen back to when we replay it even 6 months from now and be like, oh yeah, like it is just one breath. And you may from now in between then, you know, go sit in a yoga class and have this nirvana experience. You know, like some of my favorite teachers, they have this story and it's like, why do you guys put yourself in all those like difficult, weird postures? Or why are you guys like, it's so painful. And like, that's the point. Like that's to be in that area of discomfort and really say, I'm okay, is powerful, and it helps your performance, because then when the world around you gets uncomfortable, you've already dealt with that. You've already been like, I know exactly what it feels like, you know, to sit in fire log for 20 minutes and it's, you know, and all the chaos that comes in my head, and just pulling all of that back. So any of my super experienced yogis, I want you to think about how this can integrate into and give yourself a little bit of grace that you don't have to do your asanas perfect. You don't have to do the breath work perfect, but you want to slowly say, I'm dedicated to this. And I believe that when I slow down, I get better results.
I totally agree. And I have to be honest with you. Several years ago, I stepped back from my asana practice for about 2 years. And that at that moment was when I actually really started to understand yoga. I found that my addictive tendencies had filtered into my yoga and I became obsessed for the wrong reasons. And so removing myself from asana, because remember, asana is only one of the eight limbs. And yet a lot of people think that asana is yoga and there's so much more to that. And that pranayama comes before asana, or breathing comes before asana. So if you really want to challenge yourself, start to look at how you view yoga. Just like starting to pay attention to how you view your breathing. Is it really important to you? Do you really rely on it to help you get through and to draw mental clarity? There's a reason why you're taught breathing during labor. I've had 4 children. Breathing is essential if you want to get through anything hard, period. And so the more that we can go to those easy, quick things, you don't have to drive to CVS or Walgreens to fill a prescription. You don't have to pay a copay. You know, there is no refills. It's instantly accessible to you at all times. And why don't we start utilizing it more? What's your hang up? What's holding you back? Why are you willing or unwilling to see your breath as something of value and use it in your daily life? That's the challenge, but that's also the opportunity.
Yeah, thank you so much for teaching us your breath work today, Hope, and spending time really diving into how we can better ourselves and stay in that peak performance lane and not be burnt out. You know, I think when we want to go on the yoga retreat when we're burnt out, and it's like, what if we don't even get that far? And then when you go to the yoga retreat, you're having that much more fun because you're not having to like sleep it off for 2 days before experiencing the rest of it. And that's just one example, you know, of people.
Yeah. And if I can mention something else, I think for a lot of people, you know, we have the expectation of needing to do something fancy and fabulous in order for us to feel elite or progressive or advanced. And usually people are shocked when I'm just teaching them basic deep belly breathing. But here's the thing. Most people don't even know how to breathe. You would be shocked at how many people ask me, where should my belly be going when I inhale and exhale? Should it go in or should it go out? And being able to go back to that beginner place, and beginner shouldn't feel like a yucky word, but being able to go back there and really check in to see if we're utilizing these skills truly in our everyday life as someone that's a yogi, that to me is the true practice of yoga, that it is automatic as brushing my teeth, that when I'm stressed, I find myself deep breathing. When I'm anxious, I find myself deep breathing. When I'm about to go on stage in front of 1,000 people, 300 people, even 3 people, I'm breathing. That is my go-to tool. So if you want to excel as a purpose-driven millennial or retiree, or I don't care what it is, use the tools that you have and then beautify them and make them fancy later on. But let's first make sure how to use them in our own skin on a daily level. That's where you really excel, truly.
Yes. Thank you so much. Hope, where can we find you online?
Absolutely. So I'm on pretty much all social media platforms. You can find me on LinkedIn if you're more of a businessy person, but I am on Instagram, Hope Zvara or Mother Trucker Yoga. And then you can find me online as well, hopesavara.com, that's Z-V-A-R-A, or mothertruckeryoga.com. And you can check out my yoga, you can check out my blog, I have meditations, you know, pretty much a little bit for everybody.
Yeah, and speaking of meditations, I hear you have a treat for our millennial, driven millennial listeners.
Absolutely. I get it. Life is stressful. And if we can have those resources that we can instantly tap into, we're going to find ourselves going down the path we want. So I would love for the listeners on this summit to enjoy one of my 5-minute meditations to help de-stress and refocus.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Hope. And it was a pleasure chatting with you today. We'll definitely be checking you out and getting our meditation on. You're awesome.
Awesome. Thanks so much for having me.
Have a great day.